Okay, so this will be my super bad first review video. Well, not much review, but just general tech video. yesterday I received this, which comes in a nice package here. You can see that. It's four relays that are controllable by a little remote control. And you hear it click each time I press a button. Then I decided to look at it with my Flir TG165 camera to see where the hotspots are. Let's see if I can see anything here. You can kind of see a hotspot there, which I think is the voltage regulator. And here's a diode which you don't see at the moment. Let me switch on the relay. Now suddenly my camera screen went off. That's bad. That's really bad. Okay, there it is. Okay, I have to tell my camera to not switch the screen off or I see nothing. So, okay. Yeah. Kind of see a little spot there that's getting hot now, which is this diode. So I don't know why this gets hot when I'm using the relays, but I think it's just one relay now. Yeah, one relay which uses approximately 50 milliamps. What's interesting though, I wanted to get closer and nothing happens. Oh, there it was. I can, hello, can sometimes switch on and off, well actually on, it seems one of them switched on, relays with my Flir. Let me click again. Well, it doesn't want to click again. That's too bad. But yeah, at least it switched one of them on. Let's see, maybe if we isolate the antenna a bit more. Come on. It worked flawlessly yesterday. Okay. So, seems like this just worked once now. Come on. One more time. God dang it. Ah, there it is. You hear it clicking? Yeah, this, it seems that my camera has some high frequency noise that lets the thing go crazy. Not touching the remote control, it's just switching from the camera. Very interesting. So it seems that it's only A and D which are getting switched. At least yesterday I tested it and only A and D got switched. And yeah, that's my new toy which I will use to power my stereo on and off. From anywhere in the house, probably. I don't know what the distance is that these remote controls go, but I also decided I need a power supply because, well, my stereo does not have 12 volt power, at least not standby. So I decided I will just get a small wallwart like this one, which looks pretty huge if you have the casing on. But I lifted it and it's super lightweight, so of course thought, well, this is from China and it was super cheap, let's take a look inside. So I took a look inside and, well, this is what we got. Some flimsy cables going to the bottom. Let me see if I can make this more visible to you. Please work. Okay, so now we'll have now some reflections here. I don't know if you can see it, but on the top here, let me use a screwdriver to point. You have this squiggly line here that goes from the mains to the board. I guess this is what they call a fuse. So yeah, this is the crude fuse you have. Then we have a rectifier here, a big capacitor, and I don't really know why the hell this thing is here, this wire. I don't know where it's from. I guess they just tacked it on for unknown reasons. Let's look at the other side, what we have here. Well, we have a resistor and just a cap. I don't know. But yeah, if you look at the assembly quality, everything is bent to shit. That's also not very great. I did not have plugged it in yet, but yeah, I guess I have to do that at some point. Sadly, I do not have my isolation transformer here now, because the workbench is quite cluttered with a lot of shit, so yeah, no place for a transformer at the moment. But I will try it and see if I can get 12 volts out of it. According to its label, if you can read that or not, I don't know. Yeah, well, this camera does not have a focus feature, so it doesn't help if I go closer. It's supposed to do 2 amps at 12 volts. I doubt that this can do half an amp at 12 volts. luckily, if I switch all the relays on, we use 180. So I hope that this is at least capable of delivering 180 or 100 milliamps if it has to be, because I only use 2 of them. Yeah, like, either there were no 2 relay modules or they were all more expensive than this one. So I went with the with this one. And now I'm stuck with it. But it is smaller than I imagined, so that's quite nice. So we'll just put it in this enclosure inside my stereo, and hopefully I can then switch it on and off. Because my stereo is also built from parts of China, I have a Bluetooth receiver, Bluetooth receiver thingy, but it also has a line in. I had to rip out the Bluetooth module because it was just making buzzing noises all the time. So I'm again stuck with just line in. And this board has its own switch, like a hardware switch that you flip, but it uses 24 volts, so I needed a power supply. This power supply also has its own switch, which also has to be switched. So I will use 2 of the relays after I figured out what the ABC are hooked up to. I guess one of them is normally closed, one of them is normally open. And then I might be able to switch it on from the bed. The thing is, I can't just use one switch to switch on the power supply, and the board will just be always on, because then I get a lot of racket when the voltage ramps up or falls down when I switch it off. And I don't want that. Especially because I usually stay up late at night. So that's kind of bad if your, well, what, how many watts, I think 200 watt stereo goes boom when you switch it off. Okay, so I will see if I can pause the video, and I will plug this in, and if the video never gets uploaded, you know I'm dead. Okay. Okay, so this is my test setup here. We have this thing which can measure power. And then we have this thing, which goes into this, which is my very cheap USB oscilloscope, which you can see here. I already started it once to see if everything blows up, but no. It's still holding a voltage, so it means there is no discharge resistor on the output of that thing, but that isn't really important. So let's plug it in. You see the voltage spike back here? which goes up to 12.6 volts, which is okay, I think, for this thing. What's also interesting is there is a red LED. As you have seen, the case is quite black, if I find the other part of it. yeah, I don't know where I put that. Oh, back here. Yeah, it's completely black, so this LED is bullshit. So I kind of guess that whoever made this took a knockoff power supply, which is this, and a case, which is this, put the two together and sold it for, well, what was it, like $3? But okay, I don't care. But as long as it works and does not catch fire. You see the voltage, you see the power, you see the amps. Let's be careful and click the button. So, also 0 VA, and, well, is this a power factor of 0? I mean, there's no load on it at the moment. So, I think we should put one on it, and yeah, up here you can kind of see my electronic DC load, so I will set that up, and then we can see if this explodes or not. Also, we should now see how hot it gets. If my camera starts up. Yeah, pretty hot. Well, when I say pretty hot, I can't say how much. The thing is, in this camera, you can kind of see there's two sensors here. There's the big thing, which, well, looks like it would be the camera, but no. This is the actual temperature sensor, and the small thing on top is the actual image sensor. This on the bottom just does the temperature, which is, which means that if I put it here, the temperature sensor will most likely not point at it, so I have to go up a bit, and you see the temperature rise to what it thinks is like 21 degrees. If I go closer, well, it says, still says 21, so yeah, I don't know if I can trust that. Oop. Yeah, it's hard to measure. Usually I would put my hand in front of it. The thing is, I only have two hands, and I have to hold this and this. So, yeah. Can't put a foot up there because I'm not that stretchy. Okay, so, yeah, it kind of seems like this transistor gets pretty hot. Well. Let's see how hot it gets when I put a load on it. Oh boy. Okay, so I have the DC load set up, and you see it's running, it's not burning up yet. The thing is, this one is also not connected now. And the input here needs two cables, and I have a plug. The normal input here for power would need a plug, but I only have cables. And it already pulls like 130 milliamps. So I figured I will just plug in the power supply in the DC load as a, well, it's a normal power supply, and we see if that works. So let's disconnect. Well, actually, I could use this as a scope input. So we'll, I don't know if you can see this. Yeah, you can kind of see it. We'll connect the scope here and here. And the camera went off again. Show me what you're seeing. Okay, now use this. Hope I don't get a shock. Well, it's unplugged, but you never know, you never know. I should have looked more closely on the circuit of it. So I plug that in. Get a little spike on the oscilloscope, because there's still residual charge in the thing. God. Okay, so this should work. Let's see. Please don't blow up. Please don't blow up. Oh, we have a beep. So seems to be working. Yeah, we'll get 12.6 volts again. Can you see that? Okay, let's see here. This one also gets quite hot here. Camera, please. Okay, you see, this is the electronics DC load that has a hot spot, and here you see the. Oh my god. Fluoro reflections. This is getting quite hot here. I even tried to bend them away from each other. Oh wait, this is a resistor, right? It gets hot. Okay, I have to look at it without the camera. Yeah, this looks like it's just this really small resistor between those two transistors. So, yeah, I don't know whenever this will blow up, what happens then. So far, it kind of works. There will be a fan inside the power supply, so there will be cooling. Oh yeah, we're also using 2.4 watts now. Let's switch to VA. 3.4, power factor. Yeah, less than optimal. But oh well, it's a power supply from China. Basically everything in my stereo is has probably a horrible power factor, but I don't care. Kind of works. I mean, this is just like 3 watts, so I will probably keep this. So, yeah, this is running. Not exploding yet. So I guess it is safe to put it into my stereo. Even though it is made out of an old wood box, so... might catch fire, but there is already a lot of Chinese tech in there, and if that didn't catch fire yet, I guess this one will not. And if it does, well, too bad. There is actually a fuse inside the stereo, so if that shorts out, we'll probably just blow the fuse. And I have a lot of these fuses, because I only got them in a 100 pack. I don't know where I put them. Oh, I actually do, here. These thingies. Let's take a look at the fuses, if I can open it without... Okay, I have to put down the camera again. Yes. A lot of tiny fuses, as you can see. Yeah. So I will be able to recover from a broken fuse. Okay, so I guess that's it for this video. This is still going strong. It went to 12.7, which it also did last time. When plugged in with no load, so it is pretty stable, I say. Power factor didn't move, let's see. Wattage, 2.4. Yeah. Okay. See you next time!